three occasions which could turn.
Yes, that's what you can say about
it. 19, nobody else. There was that point in time, the next time that we dressed them for the penalty. Well, in the tackle.
There's a moment in your bones when the fire takes over. Blood is running, heart is pumping as the battle gets closer. They can say what they want now, 'cause we'll be screaming out. We can be heroes everywhere we go. We can have all that we ever want.
Hey. So that's important, very important. Yeah, keep going with the sharp turns, lads. Okay. Come on in the middle, he has to work his ass off. Let them come to you, let them come to you to play 1-2.
Yeah, Danny.
Come on!
Just a fuel for wanting him more than anybody against us.
Let's get someone. Just one more.
They can say what they want now. 'Cause we'll be screaming now. We can be heroes everywhere we go. We can have all that we ever want. Swinging like Ali, knocking out.
Be harder, Danny. Take place, yes, yes.
I decided to coach Adelaide when I was under 18s this year because of the talent that I saw last year with my son Luca's involvement with the under 16 squad who won the championship. Not only did they win the championship, but they played some pretty good football along the way. So I actually saw pockets and most areas on the field were covered very well. By that I mean, you know, the fullbacks were playing like true fullbacks, the centre backs were playing like true fullbacks, and the strikers were doing their job overall, all over the park. Everyone was doing their job as they should be doing. So I actually thought they were ahead of themselves in terms of their football knowledge and the way that they played their football. So the reason I put my hand up to coach this team is because I thought I could help take them to the next level, which is on the brink of potentially playing first team or at the very least playing at the best of their ability. So they're the reasons why I chose to get involved and help them out. My goals and aims with this team is just to allow every player to fulfill their potential, whether it means going on and playing the NPL or just continuing on playing 18s, reserves, or moving on to Stanley. It really doesn't matter. Just want my boys to enjoy their football, to continue learning, and achieve the best they possibly can. If we're lucky enough, and you know, we're in finals at the moment, virtually in finals, I should say, and we have a good run and we can go all the way to the grand final winner, great. If not, I actually already feel that the job's done in that way that the boys have been wanting to listen, learn, and develop their skills. That's a very good question. Managing my time between work and soccer has been extremely difficult, I must admit. I've got to take myself backwards to last year when I applied for the job as coach of the under-18s at Blue Eagles. When I applied for the job, I thought I would have more time than I did. Work-wise for me as a crush repairer actually wasn't that busy. We were just steady with our work flow, and I thought that 2021 was going to continue much the same, and I was quite happy and content with that, having a semi-decent workload at work, which could manage itself with a bit of input from me, and then being able to dedicate my time to coaching. Well, fast forward 6 months from being given that opportunity to coach the 18s, and we've found ourselves incredibly busy at work. COVID actually has been kind to my industry, the crushing industry, because people have remained in South Australia, people have come back to South Australia, and there's a lot of traffic on the road, which means a lot of car accidents. That aside, I still feel that I've been able to do it quite successfully. I've been lucky that I've got a good team at work, a team that allows me to leave work early when I need to, and get away, get home and have a quick bite to eat before I get off to soccer training. A good team that enables me not to have to be open on weekends, especially since our games are on Saturdays. So you know, it's really about the team behind me, giving me that ability to spend the time on coaching a soccer team. That aside, it's also family. A very supportive family is really helpful. Well, I can use my knowledge to help these boys in a number of ways. So it's mainly how my knowledge has been acquired over the years. Firstly, I guess it's a passion and a love for the sport. You know, it's in my family, it's in my blood. I watch a lot of football, and by watching, you learn. But the next step is playing the game and being fortunate enough to have some excellent coaches in my time. Back in my time in the early 90s at Blue Eagles, and even earlier on, playing as a junior at Campbelltown City, just about every coach that I had great football knowledge. They played at a very decent level. They were not only able to talk the talk, but they were able to walk the walk. They were able to show me how to kick a ball. They were able to show me how to position myself on a football field. So this is what I believe I have been able to put onto the boys and give them that knowledge that I've learned over the years, and be able to show them, tell them, and enable them to fulfill their potential. Okay, I'm dealing with, at the moment, with a lot of young men, boys 16 to 18 years of age. It can be a very challenging time for these young men. Life seems to be getting more difficult for everybody, and there are a lot of challenges with being that age, a lot of expectations. What I do find though, and from a personal level, is that the football, the dedication to football for these young men, helps stop them from looking for other things to do in life, such as the challenges of drugs, alcohol, going out, violence. I'm finding with my boys, they are so focused on their football that they really don't look for those sorts of things. And the longer they steer clear from that, the better they'll make decisions. When they do reach that 18, 19 years of age, they realize they don't need all those things. What they do is a good, healthy lifestyle with good people around them, with an interest such as soccer to help keep them focused. So yeah, they're the main reasons.
Yeah. Man!
Cross ball! Keep going, yes!